Good morning, students. Let us begin the discussion on geodesic problem. In the previous session, we have considered the isoperimetric problems and we have seen that the geodesic problem belongs to the category of isoperimetric problem. The geodesic problem is the problem of finding the shortest curve joining two fixed points on a given surface and lying entirely on that surface. Let g of xyz equal to 0 be a given surface. A curve on the surface is determined parametrically by three functions x equal to x of t, y equal to y of t, z equal to z of t that satisfy equation 1. And the problem of finding geodesics amounts to the problem of minimizing the arc length integral, t1 to t2, square root of x dot square plus y dot square plus z dot square dt, where x dot denotes dx by dt, y dot denotes dy by dt, and z naught denotes dz by dt. We have to minimize the above arc length integral subject to the side condition 1 and hence is an isoperimetric problem. First, we consider the general problem of finding a space curve x equal to x of t, y equal to y of t, z equal to z of t that gives a stationary value to an integral of the form integral t1 to t2 f of x dot y dot z dot dt, where the curve is required to lie on the surface g of xyz equal to 0. There is no loss of generality in assuming that the curve lies on a part of the surface where g is not equal to 0. On this part of the surface, we can solve the surface equation g of xyz equal to 0 for z and obtain z as a function of x and y, say small g of xy. Then dz by dt equal to dou g by dou x into dx by dt plus dou g by dou y into dy by dt. Thus, the problem reduces to finding unconstrained stationary functions for the integral t1 to t2 f of x dot y dot dou g by dou x dot plus dou g by dou y dot dt on substituting for z naught. Since here we have the independent variable t and the dependent variables x and y, the Euler's equations for this problem are d by dt of dou f by dou x naught, which is now dou f by dou x naught plus dou f by dou z naught into dou g by dou x minus dou f by dou x, which is now dou f by dou z naught into dou z naught by dou x equal to 0. Similarly, we get d by dt of dou f by dou y naught plus dou f by dou z naught into dou g by dou y minus dou f by dou z naught into dou z naught by dou y equal to 0. Now we will replace the terms dou z naught by dou x and dou z naught by dou y by d by dt of dou g by dou x and d by dt of dou g by dou y respectively. For this, we know that d by dt of dou g by dou x is dou by dou x of dou g by dou x into dx by dt plus dou by dou y of dou g by dou x into dy by dt, which can be written as dou by dou x of dou g by dou x into x dot plus dou g by dou y into y dot, which is dou z naught by dou x. Similarly, d by dt of dou g by dou y equal to dou by dou x of dou g by dou y into dx by dt plus dou by dou y of dou g by dou y into dy by dt, which can be written as dou by dou y of dou g by dou x x dot plus dou g by dou y y dot, which is equal to dou z naught by dou y. Thus, we can write the above Euler's equations as d by dt of dou f by dou x dot plus d by dt of dou f by dou z naught into dou g by dou x minus dou f by dou z naught into d by dt of dou g by dou x equal to 0 and d by dt of dou f by dou y dot plus d by dt of dou f by dou z naught into dou g by dou y minus dou f by dou z naught into d by dt of dou g by dou y equal to 0. Now consider the second terms in the above two equations. Applying the product rule, d by dt of dou f by dou z naught into dou g by dou x is equal to dou f by dou z naught into d by dt of dou g by dou x plus dou g by dou x into d by dt of dou f by dou z naught, and d by dt of dou f by dou z naught into dou g by dou y equal to dou f by dou z naught into d by dt of dou g by dou y plus dou g by dou y into d by dt of dou f by dou z naught. Therefore, the Euler's equation can be written as d by dt of dou f by dou x naught plus dou g by dou x into d by dt of dou f by dou z naught equal to 0 and d by dt of dou f by dou y dot plus dou g by dou y into d by dt of dou f by dou z naught equal to 0, because the terms dou f by dou z naught into d by dt of dou g by dou x and dou f by dou z naught into d by dt of dou g by dou y gets cancelled. Now differentiating capital G of x, y, z equal to 0 partially with respect to x, we get capital Gx plus capital Gz into dou g by dou x equal to 0. Thus, dou g by dou x equal to minus capital Gx by Gz. Similarly, differentiating capital G of x, y, z equal to 0 partially with respect to y, we get gy plus gz into dou by dou x of small dou by dou y of small g, sorry, capital gy of gy plus gz dou g by dou y equal to 0, that is dou g by dou y equal to minus gy by gz. Now define a function lambda of t by d by dt of dou f by dou z naught equal to lambda of t gz. So using the above relations, we can write the Euler's equations as d by dt of dou f by dou x dot equal to lambda of t gx and d by dt of dou f by dou y dot equal to lambda of t capital G y. Thus, a necessary condition for a stationary value is the existence of a function lambda of t satisfying equations 6, 7 and 8. On eliminating lambda of t from these three equations, we get d by dt of dou f by dou x naught divided by gx equal to d by dt of dou f by dou y naught divided by gy equal to d by dt of dou f by dou z naught divided by gz, which is equation 9. Then equations 9 and the equation of the surface g of xyz equal to 0 determine the extremals of the problem. The equations 6, 7 and 8 may be regarded as the Euler's equations for the problem of finding unconstrained stationary functions for the integral t1 to t2 f of x dot y dot z dot plus lambda of t into capital G of x y z dt. The only difference is that here instead of the parameter lambda we have lambda is a function of t. We can apply this result to the problem of finding geodesics on the surface g of xyz equal to 0. So here the function f equal to square root of x dot square plus y dot square plus z dot square. Then we get dou f by dou x dot equal to x dot divided by f, dou f by dou y dot equal to y dot divided by f, and dou f by dou z naught equal to z naught divided by f. Hence, equations 9 become d by dt of x dot by f divided by gx equal to d by dt of y dot by f divided by gy equal to d by dt of z dot by f divided by gz. Now let us consider the problem of finding the geodesics on the surface of the sphere x square plus y square plus z square equal to a square. So here capital G of xyz equal to x square plus y square plus z square minus a square equal to 0. Equations 10 and the above equation determine the extremals of the problem. By applying the quotient rule, we have d by dt of x dot by f equal to f into x double dot minus x dot f dot divided by f square, d by dt of y dot by f equal to f into y double dot minus y dot f dot divided by f square, and d by dt of z naught by f equal to f into z double dot minus z dot f dot divided by f square. Also, partial derivative of g with respect to x equal to 2x, partial derivative of g with respect to y equal to 2y, and gz is equal to 2z. So equation 10 is f x double dot minus x dot f dot divided by 2x f square equal to f into y double dot minus y dot f dot divided by 2y f square equal to f into z double dot minus z dot f dot divided by 2 z f square. Consider the first part. Multiplying the first portion by y and the second portion by x, we get y into f x double dot minus x dot f dot divided by 2 xy f square equal to x into f y double dot minus y dot f dot divided by 2 xy f square. Thus 2 xy f square gets cancelled and we have the numerators y into f x double dot minus x dot f dot equal to x into f y double dot minus y dot f dot. We can rewrite it in the form f into x double dot y minus x y double dot equal to f dot into x dot y minus x y dot. Now consider the second and third parts of the above equation. Similarly as above, multiply the second portion by z, third portion by y. So we get z into f y double dot minus y dot f dot divided by 2 y z f square equal to y into f z double dot minus z dot f dot divided by 2 y z f square. Similarly as above, we can rewrite it as f into y double dot z minus y z double dot equal to f dot into y dot z minus y z dot. Thus we have the ratios f into x double dot y minus x y double dot divided by f dot into x dot y minus x y dot equal to f into y double dot z minus y z double dot divided by f dot into y dot z minus y z dot equal to 1. Thus we get x double dot y minus x y double dot divided by x dot y minus x y dot equal to y double dot z minus y into z double dot divided by y dot z minus y z dot equal to f dot by f. Now consider the first two parts. An integration gives x dot y minus x y dot equal to c1 into y dot z minus y z dot. That is y into x dot plus c1 z dot equal to y dot into x plus c1 z. Or x dot plus c1 z dot divided by x plus c1 z equal to y dot by y. So a second integration gives x plus c1 z equal to c2 y. We know that this is the equation of a plane passing through the origin. So the geodesics on a sphere are arcs of great circles. This is because the point xyz must lie on the given sphere and the above plane. Thus, we have finished the discussion on the problem of geodesics. Thank you.